And now I'd like to ask Betty Webb to come forward and tell us about
Arbor Day.
Okay. The reason for my participation is today is I've been here in the past, but they asked me to come today because this year they were gracious, the Garden Committee was gracious enough to allow us to also celebrate Arbor Day today. We realize Arbor Day is the 29th, as we've been reminded recently, but we wanted to go ahead and combine forces this year to have an Earth Day and Arbor Day combination celebration. And we want to thank the Garden Committee for allowing us to be here with you. And I'm speaking actually on behalf of our tree committee. We are working very diligently to become a Tree City USA designated community. Tree City USA program is sponsored by the National Arbor Day Foundation with support from our national and our state forestry service. We are fortunate enough to have two of the Florida Division of Forestry members here with us today, Mr. Charlie Marcus, Mr. Daniel Stevens. We appreciate you being here with us. This national designation will help us protect and preserve our tree canopy. And as you all know, we are very fortunate to have a beautiful tree canopy in the city of Apalachicola. And it's also another avenue to foster our community pride. We are going to start with the tree committee is going to be given a report every month when we have our community pride meeting. So you all plan to join us and hear about that, as well as our community garden. There are four commitments that our community and our city have to make to become a Tree City USA designated community. The first one is we had to create a tree committee, which we have done that. We have a designated group that handles that. We have Jeff Huell as the chairman, Robin Grove, who is the secretary, Bruce Hall, Caroline Weiler, Susan Richardson, Beth Wright, Lois Svoboda, and Bob Horn. So we appreciate their efforts to be the volunteers for our group. And I think a lot of you are here today, so raise your hand so they can see you're here.
Good.
We appreciate your efforts. The second thing we had to do is the City Commission had to adopt a tree ordinance, a tree protection ordinance, and the mayor and the commission did that back in January, so we're pleased that they supported the community in creating this ordinance. The third thing we have to do is we have to have volunteer and city in-kind commitment. That can be anything in-kind, like for instance, our tree committee is doing a survey of our inventory of trees in the city. They're going to highlight anything that is a significant species type tree. And we're also going to put that on our GIS mapping system, so we'll be able to share a map with Bobby Pickles when he comes to trim our trees, and they'll know the ones we're protecting and we don't want him to touch. The fourth thing we have to do is we have to have an Arbor Day event. So as I said earlier, the Garden Committee allowed us to participate today for our Arbor Day event this year. And there's a few things we're going to do to recognize Arbor Day. As you may know, across the street there is a tree that was donated by Bill and Amanda Kohler from the garden shop. We appreciate that. That's going to be planted as an Arbor Day activity. The second thing is the mayor has a proclamation that he is going to read for us.
Thank you so much, Betty.
I didn't prepare for this. He's going to read it.
Whereas in 1872, J. Sterling Martin proposed to the Nebraska Board of Agriculture that a special day be set aside for the planting of trees. And whereas the holiday called Arbor Day was first observed with the planting of more than 1 million trees in Nebraska. And whereas Arbor Day is now observed throughout the nation and the world. And whereas trees can reduce the erosion of our precious topsoil by wind and water, lower our heating and cooling costs, moderate the temperature, clean the air, produce oxygen, and provide habitat for wildlife. And whereas trees are a renewable resource, giving us paper wood for our homes, fuel for our fires, and countless other wood products. And whereas trees in our city increase property value, enhance the economic viability of business area, and beautify our community. And whereas trees, wherever they are planted, are a source of joy and a spiritual renewal. Now, therefore, I, Van W. Johnson, Sr., Mayor of the City of Apalachicola, do hereby proclaim April 22nd, 2011, as Arbor Day in the City of Apalachicola, Florida. And I urge all citizens to celebrate Arbor Day and support efforts to protect our trees and woodlands.